of one who has a pleasant voice who can play well on the instrument, for they hear your words, but they do not do them. And when this comes to pass, and it will come, says, then they will know that a prophet has been among them. Because you know what's going to be sad is even one day they're going to know that everything that you were speaking to their lives was true. One day they're going to realize, man, a prophet had been among us, and we didn't listen to it at all. One day they're going to come to a point, what he's trying to tell you and I is one day judgment day is coming. One day it's all going to be over. And we can never say, God, I never heard your word before. I never heard what you said, God. God said, no, that day, every time you came to church, you heard the word of God, but you never listened to it, never obeyed it. That's the difference, you guys, between them and us. It should be like, wait a minute, I'm coming today because I want God in my life. I'm coming today because I want to hear God, walk with God, speak with God, love God, think with God. I want to do my all with my God. Today, let not just be our lives in it. That's what's happening in David's time. They just came, they were God's people, we're going to worship God, do all these things, and God says, listen, that's why that man died. He came in his own way. He's not coming to listen. He's not coming to honor. He's not coming to obey. He's doing his own thing. And you die when you do your own thing. I say that today to you guys because God wants the power of God in your lives. God wants it in your marriage, in your life. Some of you right now, even as I speak, you look at your life and say, man, you know what? Why has all this happened in my life? Could it be that God is saying, listen, I'm not going to move until you move. I'm not going to sit there and do nothing until you come real with me. That's how God is. God loves us today. But God's not going to bless disobedience. God only blesses obedience in our lives. The next verse I want you to do is for leaders, where God says to Israel again, a son honors his father and a servant his master. If then I am your father, where's my honor? God's speaking to Israel, if I'm your father, where's my honor? Where's my respect, then, he says? And if I'm a master, where's my reverence? If I'm your father, then where's my honor? If I'm your master, where's my reverence? Where's my respect at, then, he says? He says, the Lord of hosts, to you priests who despise my name, yet you say, in what way we despise your name? You offer defiled food on my altar, and when you have defiled you by saying the table of the Lord is contemptible, and when you offer the blind a sacrifice, it is not evil, and when you offer the lame and sick, it is not evil, offering to your governor. And all that saying in a nutshell, listen, why are you giving me the weakness of your life when you should be the best of your life all the time? How many of God deserves our best? He deserves our kind of God attention. He deserves our whole heart. He deserves our whole life. He deserves our all today. And it's very, very important today that we say, God, I want to give you my all today. I want to give you my heart. I'm going to know God wants to press with God's side of the house. So after God's done today, and you have the family going to come up today, I want you to know and understand today that God desires that his presence will go with us every step of the way. But we have to understand as God's people. We have to be able to come and say, man, God, I know that I don't deserve nothing, but you're my Lord, you're my all. And I'm coming to you right now, God, with my whole heart, my soul, and my mind. Today, I know that God is speaking to us.